Good evening, everyone. Graduates, please be seated wherever you are. It is my honor and privilege to welcome you to the School District of Elmwood's commencement ceremony for the class of 2020. I'm extremely proud to stand here tonight in front of a camera preparing this speech as a superintendent of such a great school. This school is lathered in pride and tradition, stemming back to the first Elmwood school that was on the corner of Highway 72 and 128 in 1887. The first school building on this site in 1902. The first high school graduation that occurred here in 1911. And now, the first virtual graduation ceremony being held here tonight, May 21st, 2020. Not only is this the first virtual ceremony being held for our students, but also we will honor our first ever Western Wisconsin virtual charter school graduate here this evening. There are many people to thank for keeping these long-standing traditions going and also for getting tonight's graduates to where they are today. There are some I would like to recognize at this time. Now, normally I'd ask you to stand and be recognized and then sit back down, but I don't have to do that since there is nobody here with me right now. Parents and graduates, parents of the graduates, grandparents of graduates, great-grandparents of graduates, teachers and support staff, future teachers in the class of 2020, local community members that are healthcare workers, including some of those in the class of 2020. Local community members that have defended this country in the military in the past in order to allow us our freedoms and allow us the free public education that we are so lucky to have and that all of tonight's graduates have taken advantage of. For our police officers that defend us all the time and keep us safe in our communities, and many others who aren't able to be with us here this evening. Also like to put out a special thanks to our Chief of Police Officer Thibodeau, the Elmwood Area Fire Department, the Elmwood Community Club, the Elmwood Enrichment Council, and numerous other local individuals who helped to honor our seniors over the past few weeks. Thank you for helping our graduates get to where they are today, and for helping to continue the great traditions of the School District of Elmwood that have been around for over 135 years. Graduates, congratulations. As you leave the halls of Elmwood and your high school computer screens, be proud of where you came from. You lived through an experience that no other graduate has ever lived through in the history of public education. Those memories will last for ages. No one will ever forget the experiences we all shared during the spring of 2020. I would now like to invite Mr. Thomas Sabe, middle school, high school principal, to the podium to get this celebration continued. As I pass the microphone to Mr. Sabe, I want to thank him for a tremendous job he has done in his first year as a middle school, high school principal, especially with navigating through COVID-19 closures, working tirelessly to provide the best experience he could, including putting together this virtual ceremony for the class of 2020. Mr. Sabe, thank you. The show is now yours.
Thank you, Dr. Webb. I would like to thank everyone for joining us tonight to celebrate the outstanding class of 2020. Today is going to look and feel a little bit different with our obvious current situation. Most elements of previous year's ceremonies are still intact. Student speeches, keynote speakers, and of course, the beloved senior slideshow. With many of our traditions, we have also started some new traditions as well. Hopefully using YouTube is only a one-year deal. At this time, I would like to take the opportunity to thank the staff at Elmwood. None of what has happened over the last 8 weeks would be possible without their diligent efforts to make sure that they deliver the best education possible to not just the seniors, but all of our students here at Elmwood School District. Your hard work has not gone unnoticed, and we thank you. At this time, I would like to bring up our first speaker for the night, Mr. Jeff Pickering.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Your families, friends, school, and community are extremely proud of you, and rightfully so. It is my distinct honor to introduce Elmwood's 2020 salutatorian. Of course, those who know her need no introduction, but allow me to briefly describe her for those who have yet to enjoy the wonderful privilege of meeting this future UW-Eau Claire biology student. Our salutatorian is a delightful young lady who displays compelling contrasts of personal qualities. This naturally curious student is at once an excellent role model, yet quiet leader, fierce competitor, but encouraging classmate, and inquisitive academic with an appreciation for Earth's caretakers as well as society's skilled trade workers. Her courteous demeanor graces any room, along with her joyous smile, although she is quick to shed a tear upon sensing someone near her is in a moment of hurt. Equally adept at handling an opposing point guard, biology lab, volleyball serve, welding torch, relay baton, calculus problem, horse reins, and conservation speech, this team player has earned the mutual respect of peers, teachers, coaches, and the community. I proudly present to you Elmwood's 2020 salutatorian, Catherine Rebecca Fuca.
Hello, everyone. These past 2 weeks have been nothing like we expected, but the class of 2020 has made the best of it. At the beginning of the year, we wanted nothing more than to go home and get some more sleep. We hope for more snow days, less homework, and even better grades. Going where we wanted to after lunch was one of our favorite ways to irritate Mr. B. Some of us like to push the limits to see how late we could show up in class without getting tardy. This didn't mean that we didn't like going to school. We were just really excited to graduate. Our days of slamming lockers and being weird in the hallways abruptly transformed into rolling out of bed 5 minutes before class, logging onto your computer, and hoping that no one noticed that you hadn't changed clothes in 3 days. Despite our new learning from home format, most of us managed to get our work done. But suddenly, we missed being at school. Now, we will always be remembered as the class that got quarantined. Sports seasons, recognition ceremonies, trips, and other competitions canceled or delayed. Many of us feel cheated because we didn't get to have the senior year we envisioned. Why us? None of us wanted this to happen. Quarantine has taught us to take nothing for granted. Remember this as you move on in life. Cherish the memories you make each day. Learn in the classroom or on the couches at home. The knowledge and lessons we gained during our time at Elmwood will be carried with us forever. Underclassmen, no matter what you choose to devote your time to in high school, make it great. Remember that every race you run or class project you complete could be your last. If you're having a rough day, think of the good times with your friends at school. These moments will not last forever. Take the time to get to know your teachers and coaches. They go to school every day to help you. The sooner you realize that, the easier it will be for everyone. It may be hard to believe, but they were once in your shoes. Having someone to turn to for advice makes the difficult days a lot easier. Step outside of your comfort zone and try something new. Be bold and join a club that your friends aren't in. It may surprise you how quickly new friendships will blossom before your eyes. Remember that effort is one of the most important factors to success. Even if you are not the best in the beginning, your commitment will speak louder than words in the end. If you put time in, you will see the results. Always do your best and you will set yourself up for success. Always respect your peers, coworkers, people younger than you, those in authority, and especially your parents. As Mr. Pickering would say, how are you going to leave your legacy in Elmwood. Next, I would like to thank all the teachers, staff, and administrators that have made our graduation possible. Teachers, you helped us survive the quarantine and brought smiles to our day. I personally look forward to hearing from you, even if it was from a computer screen, to give me more homework. Coaches, I'm sure many of you are just as bummed about the sports season as us. To every coach that I have had since fourth grade basketball, thank you. The lessons you taught our teams are just as important as the information we obtained in the classroom. Thank you for believing in us on our worst days. Teachers, coaches, and mentors, you have touched our lives in beautiful ways. Seniors, as we take this next step into the future, take a moment to look at what you have already accomplished. We come from a small school with big opportunities. The ball is in your court, take it and run. Be confident, be bold, but most importantly, be you. Never miss out on an opportunity to do something that will make you happy. COVID-19 may have thrown a wrinkle into some of our plans, but it doesn't define you or who you will become. We are future teachers, lawyers, nurses, farmers, construction workers, scientists, but most importantly, we are friends. Never forget that. We worked together to do some pretty amazing things the last 4 years. I wouldn't take it back for the world. So as we close this chapter in our lives, take a moment to think about your classmates, siblings, and mentors. Thank them for being a part of your journey thus far. Just because it is time for us to act like adults doesn't mean we have to do it alone. Senior class of 2020, despite a worldwide pandemic, you are all graduating. Congratulations. Continue to ride the roller coaster, because Kenny Chesney once said, life goes faster than you think, so don't blink.
Good evening, and welcome to tonight's graduation ceremony. My name is Bailey Byard, and this is my first year teaching math at Elmwood. However, some of you may know me from 2012, when I was on this very stage about to give my own valedictorian speech. During that speech, I wished everyone the best as we set off to try to make Elmwood a better place. I never thought that would bring me back to Elmwood. After coming back to Elmwood and meeting Ms. Taylan DeLong, I knew that she was one of the best students that I ever had the opportunity to work with. Taylan has all the qualities that represent an exemplary student. She has an incredible passion for knowledge. In pre-calculus, she was always inquiring about the relationships between concepts to solidify her understanding. She is extremely kind. I have seen on numerous occasions Taylan work with underclassmen, helping them make connections between concepts and core classes such as math, to helping them learn how to read sheet music for choir. She is respectful and a natural leader. If something can be done in a more efficient way, Taylan will speak up in a way that is respectful to everyone. Al and Tanya should be proud that they raised such a respectful young woman. In her time in Elmwood, Taylan did as much as possible to make Elmwood a better place, as well to push herself to be the best person possible. She was a leader of her softball and volleyball team, lettering for multiple years. In the music department, she made many accomplishments from attending Dorian Vocal Festival multiple years, taking part in state solo and ensemble for many years for both band and choir, to playing taps to honor the men and women who have given their lives for our country. She attended state forensics for 3 years, helping her become an excellent public speaker. She has also led every school organization possible, being the class president for 4 years, FCCLA president for 2 years, student council president for 2 years, and National Honor Society president for 2 years. In my time since returning to Elmwood, I have seen the tremendous impact that Taylan made on Elmwood as a whole. Taylan will be missed, but I guarantee that she will continue to leave a positive impact wherever she goes. Next year, she will be attending UW-La Crosse. Taylan does not yet know what she wants to study, but I know that she will be successful in whatever she chooses. Who knows, maybe Elmwood will be lucky enough to have Taylan return to Elmwood someday, to leave Elmwood as a better place.
Taylan, I wish you the best as you continue to grow and leave a positive impact in the world every single day. Now, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor to introduce the valedictorian of the class of 2020, Ms. Taylan DeLong.
Well, we finally made it. I know this is most definitely not how we expected to finish our senior year. 3 months ago, we were all saying how ready we were to finally be done and how we just wanted a day off. This is our like couch for relax. This is not what we meant in the slightest. In some ways, though, this is just a group over our class. It seemed like every year, we were just a year shy of the changes that happened. When we left second grade and moved to the bigger playground, they expanded the smaller one we just left. Then, when we left fifth grade, they did it to us again. They remodeled the playground we had just left and didn't get to use anymore. Finally, when we left middle school and entered high school, they changed the grade policy and allowed middle school students to take advanced classes with us. So it only makes sense that once again, as we move on to a new stage of our lives, we are hit with a curveball, just like usual. This may not be the normal or ideal situation, but our class is definitely not normal. A class like ours can't just have a normal graduation. We, of course, have to get with something different and find a new way to work around it like we do best. Now, before I start sharing all the members our class has compiled over the years, there are a lot of thank yous that deserve to be given out. Without the people standing by our side each step of the way, we would not be where we are today. First, I'd like to thank my parents. And all of the parents. Without your support, I would have never grown to be the girl standing here before you giving this speech. Thank you, Mom, for the endless nights of studying with me to the point where you swore you knew the material better than I did. Thank you, Dad, for always wishing me to be my best, and when I was down, telling me to suck it up, princess. Secondly, I'd like to thank all the staff here at the school. You guys have seen us at our best and at our worst. Now that 50% of my teachers have seen me in my pajamas over Google Meets at some point during this time, you guys have seen me at my worst, and we have created a bond to last forever. You know exactly how to motivate each and every one of us to live up to our full potential. Especially in times like these, it helps me remember that none of this would be possible without you. You have taught us skills not only to help us move through high school, but ones that will last with us for a lifetime. If this situation has taught me anything, it is that our staff here in Elmwood will do anything for our students, and that they all really do love their jobs. Next, I'd like to thank the community. Without your support of not only our class, but also our school district as a whole, we wouldn't have so many of the great opportunities we have all experienced during our time here. Whether you were screaming family stands during our sporting events, or laughing in depth and enjoying our talents at our classes, you have been a great part of our experience here at Elm High School. Now, to thank my classmates and share a few of the many stories we have created while we were together. When I think of the class of 2020, there are many words that come to mind to describe us. Goofy, sarcastic, fun-loving, adventurous, talented, driven, procrastinators, but most importantly of all, family. Growing up in such a small community has allowed our class to connect on a level so much deeper than any larger school. Not only do I know each person by name and recognize their faces when we walk past each other in the hall, I know each one of my classmates' middle names, birthdays, where they live, and enough information to pose as any one of them if we ever meet. This connection has formed our class into a small, inseparable family that has made so many memories of each other throughout the years. Now, like any family, our class has a typical dynamics. We have the troublemakers, who started off day one as so. Our best example of the troublemakers in our class was our sixth grade year. We took a field trip to one of Elmwood tour, and Mr. Sears drummed at Mason that he couldn't steal a goose. Now, if any of you know Mason, he doesn't turn out bad. So he stole the goose and kept it in his backpack the entire ride. Now don't think that we let Mason be all on his own on this secret. Oh no. We are all true troublemakers at heart, so we all knew and helped him keep it a secret. The code word for any time we wanted to talk about the goose was the pineapple in Mason's backpack. When Mason got the goose home, his backpack was completely destroyed. but he won the bet, and that was all that mattered. The next year dynamic that is clearly seen in our class is the fun lovers. We all love to have a good time and make memories. This is especially true when we are supposed to be paying attention, like in any one of the release classes. We could not sit still for long in the release class, so that either meant we were talking or we were sleeping. In either case, Mr. B would throw any one of his various objects on his very cluttered desk at us. Well, one day, he let slip that he wanted a squirt gun to squirt us with when we weren't paying attention. So we did like any rational class would do, we bought him a squirt gun. But we also bought our own squirt guns. The next day, when someone fell asleep in class and Mr. B went to squirt them with a squirt gun, you better believe that Trevor and I had ours in the ready and fired back. This led to a giant squirt gun fight in the middle of world geography, which now explains why I barely know which country is Europe. Our next family dynamic is the family secrets. Our class has always been particularly good at keeping secrets, or so we think we are. This is especially true this year when we tried to hide the significant damage that we had done outside of Mr. B's room. I won't get into specific details, but it had to do with one person pushing another person into a glass case outside of Mr. B's door. Within 5 seconds of hearing the telltale crack glass breaking, we all parted like the Red Sea away from said glass. Then, as Mr. B walked up the stairs, we put on our innocent little kid smiles that any parent can see right through, and pretended we had no idea what happened. Eventually, Mr. B got the story out of us, but he couldn't stay mad at us for long, and he gave us the typical, "You know I love you, right?" Mr. B speech. Finally, we have the lovers. Now, I know that sounds kind of weird when I say this in terms of family, but trust me, I just think the kids who have always had romance on lines, even in kindergarten. We actually have a few great examples of this, from our own kindergarten weddings on the playground each day, and even our very own kid love triangle. Each day at recess, a new girl would be getting married, usually to Mason because he was the only guy who ever supplied rings for us girls, and the whole class would gather around to witness the ceremony. Lucky for us, none of these marriages were legally binding, or half the girls in our class would be walking around with big old rocks on their fingers. As for the kid love triangle, we may not be able to tell, but back in the day, our very own boat number was quite a ladies' man. I mean, I don't know if you saw that Italian pizza connoisseur style mustache he was rocking in our slideshow, but I assure you, back in the day, he was the root of a little kindergarten love triangle. As the story goes, the little blonde-haired 5-year-old Taylor was dating Bo, but little did I know he was dating Kendra at the same time. Well, when Kendra found out that same day at lunch, she did as any angry kindergartner would do. She broke the cafeteria fork in half and then confronted Bo about the situation. Don't worry, y'all. Kendra's hold a grudge, and she and I were able to move past the whole love triangle by sitting on our spots in the classroom rug and deciding that all boys had cooties. Now, as we've moved on from our kindergarten weddings to breaking trophy lift cases, we have learned so much from this little school. We have all grown into the amazing people and class that we are today. And I don't think that this day would be so sad if I had spent the past 14 years with any other group of people. We have made so many memories over the years and have truly grown to become a little family. Though we may not be ending this journey the way we planned, there are so many great things that have led up to this point that make it so special. We are the very first class to experience such a unique graduation ceremony. We paved the way for a whole new outlook on how graduation can be done. We have all faced this new and scary experience with such hopeful and brave hearts, and in hope that we continue to have the same outlook in the years to come. These next adventures that life has to offer can either be scary or the best times of our life. It all just depends on whether or not we have a bright outlook. Continue to hold your heads high, and always remember that Elmwood is your home. Even if we all travel miles and miles from here, we can always come back and share our stories, and this wonderful small community will welcome us with open arms. Now go out there and face this next adventure the same way we have faced each challenge that has come our way, ready to move past the obstacles however we can to reach our perfect end.
Good evening, and welcome to the Class of 2020's graduation ceremony. As with every one of you watching here tonight, I've been waiting for this for a long time. I also know that all of you, just like me, wish it was under completely different circumstances. I was so excited this fall when this group of seniors asked me to do the graduation speech. Funny thing is, it wasn't a surprise because they had been asking me since their sophomore year. I think it had to do with the fact that when they were freshmen, I called them one of my favorite classes of all time. First things first, many are not going to understand parts of this speech, and that's okay. The speech was written for them, and it is their night. And if there's a group that could use a night like this, it is them. So in the original speech, I was going to point to them and bring up the new catchphrase in education, what is my why? Well, it is them. The young men and women of this class have been a special part of my life for a while now. A very special part that I had the blessing of being around for 4 years. I can't think of a better why than them. Now, they've asked me if I was going to mention every one of their names, and that's probably not going to happen because of the fact that if I had the opportunity to do that, I would spend all night up on this stage talking about them. They're a wonderful group with a lot of different personalities and stories that could take all night. So some of you may have heard this group over the years call me Dad. It does create some interesting looks as I might have five or six say to some person that is not familiar with their school walk by. This started their sophomore year. Our boys basketball team was playing up at the Target Center. And we had an opportunity to take the kids up there and then afterwards watch a Timberwolves game. Well, the Target Center rules stated that we needed to have one parent for every one or two children. And we just couldn't get everybody to go. So what we figured out over time was that we could have me adopt these kids. So that night I adopted a group of the seniors and we went to the Target Center. It was kind of a hilarious night with the fact that they're walking around yelling Dad. It was a group of about 6 to 8 of them that would be constantly yelling there. And they had fun with it, but my goodness, I could not have asked for a better behaved group and a more well-mannered group. I was so proud of how they acted that night on the bus. We went out to eat. That was a credit to them and the real moms and dads that have raised them. So as time went on, I was greeted most mornings by a hello, Dad. Another thing that would not happen in a lot of schools, but I was lucky enough to end up at one of the schools where it did. You know, since they were freshmen, I knew there was something special about this group, and that they could really take on all challenges. They had what I always like to call the it factor. Now, they're a little needy and insecure at times, but when they finally feel sure about what they're doing, they soar to unbelievable heights. What an amazing 4 years for this group. Their accomplishments in academics, arts, athletics, clubs, and music have been amazing. They took advantage of what was placed in front of them and ran. I'd like to say without any complaints, but I'm betting that the moms and dads out there know better. One of my favorite phrases of all time is, but Mr. B. Well, the first 2 years went pretty well. Then comes year three, the year of the never-ending snow day. One or two snow days are fine, but after having to rearrange and then rearrange schedules, it got to be sickening. We even had days added on at the end of the school year, not something that any high school kid wants. Well, they handled that. They were now soon to be a senior class that had lived through the never-ending winter. We all learned about virtual classroom and this Fandango Google Classroom stuff over the summer, so we were going to be ready for whatever Mother Nature threw our way in the next winter. Then the senior year came. We hit the ground running. By the way, I used we a lot with them. It's because even though I had to be the authority figure, we still had a relationship where we understood that if we wanted this to be an awesome year, we would do it together. The very first day of school this year, the teachers had to say our name and the number of years we taught in Elmwood. Also happened that when it got to me, I mentioned that I was going on my 26th year. The senior class stood up and gave me a standing ovation. Not something that they had to do, but I was very humbled that day and realized how blessed I was to be able to work with them. I'll also never forget that this group is the one that took my son under their wing when he came during their sixth grade year. Not something they had to do, but boy, did that sure help a sixth grade boy who was coming from a different school district. And they did this because they were incredible humans. For that, I will always be grateful. We started the year strong. Our time together was great. Even though we were working through a second year superintendent and a first year principal, we knew he had it under control. This group understood the nuances of what goes with these changes, and they worked very hard to get our new principal, you know, to know our new principal. To his credit, Mr. Sabe saw greatness in this group, and he worked hard. He worked hand in hand with them to make it a great year. That being said, the if the day ever came where I had to start a business, I would hire this group, and I'd be willing to bet that my business would be one of the best in the area. They have everything you need to be successful. Everyone has their own talents and skills, and when given a chance, they shine in those areas. They also have great people skills, and they are unbelievably passionate human beings. One of the places that I learned a lot about them throughout the years was in the lunchroom. Not too many people would say as teachers that they love being in the lunchroom, but being able to work with this group and listening to the stories that they had and being able to deal with them on a different level was fabulous, and that's the one thing that I missed over the last few months, was being able to be with them at lunch duty. But we got through our fall and winter. They were easy, no real hiccups. So we started talking about our lives and futures. Every so often, Mr. Sabe would come to visit. I think he came to observe this class more often because he knew that the conversations about the topics at hand were going to be lively and entertaining. I did not think that I have to tell any of you that they have minds of their own and they will speak when given the opportunity. So then we started hearing rumors of this oncoming situation. It was discussed and we said that it will not change our lives, and May 22nd will be the night where we get to celebrate all of the accomplishments throughout their years. Well, we were proven wrong. On March 13th, we were told we were not going to be able to see each other for a while. We probably should have lined them up for hugs that day, but we were practicing social distancing at that time. It got harder and harder each time we got word from our health department. As much as we tried to believe that we were going to get a real ceremony, we kind of realized that things were not looking good. But once again, as disappointed as they were, it did not stop them from being amazing students and people throughout our virtual time together. As the year went on, I had some ideas about what we would talk about tonight. Originally, it was going to be about perseverance, but it was going to be of a simpler nature. Just how I admired the never-say-die attitude of this group. Now it's about persevering through one of the greatest obstacles that we have ever faced. These graduates have been denied all that goes with the senior year and has nothing to do with anything that they have done. It was not their fault, and that is the hardest part of this whole ordeal. I've always told them that we cannot get upset or worry about the things that we cannot control. That being said, if there was a time in their lives that we could forgive them for being upset and worried about things that they cannot control, this was the time. The thing is, I believe that they have handled it with amazing grace. And I know that this group will come out better than most. One thing that they have going for them is the new t-shirts out there that say that they are the senior skip day champions. I highly doubt that anyone will ever take that title from them. In wrapping up tonight, what I would like to say is to the senior class, you are amazing. I told you that from day one. Always believe in yourself. Each and every one of you has a special gift given to you by God. I've seen it, and as you know, I'm always right. You can be whomever you want to be. Do yourself proud. Be the most amazing you that you can be. After what you've gone through and dealt with, nothing should be able to get in your way. In my mind, you have passed this with flying colors. I'm so proud of you, and I cannot wait to see just how bright your futures become. Thank you. God bless each and every one of you.
I'll be there for you. 'Cause you're there for you, get to you. curtain. No more lies, I'm tired of hurting. I think you know what I mean. There's an empty sound the lonely makes. Don't know how much more that I can take. And yesterday is just a dream. Gotta do, and I've gotta like it or not. She's got dreams too big for this town, and she needs to give them a shot wherever they are. Looks like she's all ready to leave, nothing left to pass. Ain't no room for me in that car, even if she asks me to tag along. God, I gotta be strong. She's at the starting line of the rest of her life, as ready as she's ever been. Got the hunger and the stars in her eyes, the prize is hers to win. She's waiting on my blessings before she hits that open road. Better get ready, get set.
I turned on the evening news, saw an old man being interviewed, turning 102 today. I asked him what's the secret to life. He looked up from his old pipe, laughed and said, all I can say is, don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap, and you wake up and you're 25. Then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink, you just might miss your babies growing like mine did, turning into moms and dads. Next thing you know, you better have a 50 years is there in bed. And you pray and God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think. So don't blink.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Excuse me, ma'am, I saw you walking. I turned around, I'm not a stalker. Where you going? Maybe I can help you. A tank is full, I'd be obliged to take you. Cause I'm a country boy, I got a four-wheel drive. Climb in my bed, I'll take you for a ride. Up city streets, down country roads, I can get you where you need to go. Cause I'm a country boy. Looking back now, well, it makes me laugh. We were growing our hair, we were cutting class. Knew it all already, there was nothing to learn. We were striking matches just to watch them burn. Listen to our music just a little too loud. We were hanging in there with the outcast crowd. Heading to the rapids with some discount beer. It was a long train trestle, but we had no fear. Man, I don't know where the time goes, but it sure goes fast. Just like that, we were wannabe rebels that didn't have a clue. In our rock and roll t-shirts and our typically bad attitude, had no excuses for the things that we've done. We were brave, we were crazy, we were mostly young. Young. Years old, couple cane poles sitting down by the creek. Lines in the water, watching those bobbers, seeing that red sun sink. Mama's on the porch yelling, supper's hot, y'all come and get it. We yelled five more minutes. At 16, it was 12:03, standing at her front door. Katie's dad said midnight, but we needed just a little more. Yellow light flipping on and off, interrupting that goodnight kissing. We wanted five more minutes. Time rolls by, the clock don't stop. I wish I had a few more drops of the good stuff, the good times. Oh, but they just keep on flying right on by like it ain't nothing. I wish I had me a pause button. Moments like those, Lord knows I'd hit it and give myself five more minutes. At 18, turned my helmet in, walked to the 50-yard line. Just the coach and me, after we lost 8-10-9. And I cried, man, next time to get in here I'll have to buy a ticket. Can't you give me five more minutes? Time rolls by, the clock don't stop. I wish I had a few more drops of the good stuff, the good times. Oh, but they just keep on flying right on by like it ain't nothing. Wish I had me a pause button. Moments like those, Lord knows I'd hit it and give myself five more minutes.
Small town girl living in a lonely world. Staring out the window of their SUV, complaining, saying, I can't wait to turn 18.
To the class of 2020, it is an honor and privilege to be able to celebrate all of you wonderful students on a night like tonight. When I think back to this group of seniors in Elmwood, I will remember how they were grit personified. In what is undoubtedly a hard situation for many, you, the class of 2020, handled yourself with grace, dignity, and class. Your willingness to put your fellow classmates ahead of yourselves will leave a legacy for what leadership should look like at Elmwood High School. That legacy will reach far and wide for future classes inside these walls. On behalf of the staff of the Elmwood School District, I would like to wish you the best of luck in your future endeavors. We are excited to watch you go out and change our world for the better. Please don't be a stranger and come back and visit us as well. At this time, I will read the names for the awarding of the diplomas, which you will pick up tomorrow night.
Taylan Rose DeLong. Catherine Rebecca Fuker. Madison Marie Klink. McKenna Marie Garretts. Thomas James Asher. Matthew John Basil Baker. Allie Joe Bauer. Jack Vincent Brown. Araya Renee Danielle Carson. Logan Michael Christman. Bo William Crownhart. Jaden Daniel DeLong. Dallas Louise Driscoll. Cody James Erickson. Bailey Joe Ginsbach. Jackson Alexander Glompy. Kendra Lara Kern. Mason John Peters. Brenna Lynn Schutz. Shonda Ray Trainer. Kylie Lynn Chumperlin. Trevor William Tingey. Austin Michael Yoder.